Hey guys, it's Jay, and today I'm here with the mid-year book freakout tag. I do this tag every year, but as always, I am very behind on the trends, and I always upload it in the middle of July because I can't get my life together. But this tag was originally created by Chami and Ellie, so I'll leave up both their links down below if you want to check out their channels. But there are quite a few questions, so without further ado, let us get started. The first question is, what is the best book you've read so far in 2019? My best book is a sequel, so this is technically the answer for the second question, but I chose a different one so that, you know, I could have different books for every question. But the best book I've read in 2019 is Arch Enemies by Marissa Meyer. This is the second book to the Renegades trilogy. I'm so excited for Supernova, just saying. I love this series, it's one of my favorites. I'm in love with every single character in this book, so I'm very excited to see where the story goes, but definitely the best book I've read so far. The next question is the best sequel you've read in 2019, and like I said, Arch Enemies is the best sequel I've read, but we're going to pick a close second so that I can have different books for every question, and it's Before the Devil Breaks You by Libba Bray. This is the third book in the Diviners series. Technically, I read Lair of Dreams in 2019 as well, I think. I might have read it at the end of 2018, to be honest. I can't remember. So we're going with this one because I know for a fact I read it, but again, this is another series that I just love. I love all the characters. I just want to protect them at all costs, and this book just destroyed me, so that's all I'm gonna say about it, but I cannot wait for the fourth book coming out in February. The next question is, what is a new release that you haven't read yet but want to? And I'm going with Wilder Girls by Rory Power, and I'm actually going to be reading this very shortly. It's like a YA horror book. I'm a huge fan of horror, so I'm very excited to see this book, and people have been raving about it on YouTube and Twitter, so I need to see if the hype is worth it. And I'm always behind on the hype. I'm actually in the middle of the hype for once. The next question is your most anticipated release for the second half of the year. I'm going with Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. I am so lucky that Raincoat's book sent me an ARC of this. I'm so excited to read it because I know so many people are like looking for it, wanting to read it, so I feel very honored, and I'm definitely going to be checking it out very soon. From the people who have read it, they've been raving about it and saying that it's one of their favorite books, so I am so ready to join the bandwagon. I've never read a Leigh Bardugo book. I feel like I'm a fake fan because like I haven't read one of her books, but the Grisha series and Six of Crows, I own them, have not read them, but I really want to read this, and like, it's a standalone, so I say I'm allowed to read it before the other ones. The next question is biggest disappointment. I actually have two for these. They were super popular YA books that were released. First one, Shadow of the Fox by Julie Kagawa. Second one was Furyborn by Claire LeGrand, that's who it is. I thought they were both super boring, and I was really disappointed because Sawkill Girls I loved, and the Talon series I loved, both by those two authors. But these two books, not a fan. They were so boring, and I was so upset about it because like they're people's favorite books, and I just could not with them. I got rid of them, which is why we're inserting pictures of them instead. The next question is biggest surprise, and I have a series for this that really, really took me by surprise. It is Black Witch and Iron Flower, both by Lori Forrest. This is part of the Black Witch Chronicles. I believe she's writing the third book right now. I know that these had a lot of criticism thrown at them when they were first released, which 100% valid for the people who made those criticisms. I really enjoyed them. I wanted to read them to see where I stood on that whole aspect of the criticisms. I really enjoyed them. I didn't expect to like them as much as I did. I'm really excited to see where the story goes in the third one. I suggest checking them out. Just be aware of the criticism that surround them. If that's something you think will trigger you, don't pick them up. Personally, I really enjoyed them. Big surprise. The next question is favorite new author. This can either be a debut or just new to you, and I am going with Natasha Nagan. She wrote Girls of Paper and Fire. I believe this is her debut as well. Also new to me author. This could also be considered big surprise for me. I didn't think I was gonna like it as much as I did, but this story was so good. The sequel is coming out very shortly. Very excited about it. I'm obsessed with this book. Definitely check it out if you haven't already. Although it's been super popular on BookTube, I'm sure you've read it, but if you have not, I suggest you do. The next question is newest fictional crush. I honestly had a very hard time coming up with one of these because I've been reading a lot of sequels and like trying to finish off the series that I've read. So the crushes that I have haven't really been new because I had them previously, but I just started Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas, so I'm gonna say Prince Dorian. I really enjoy him. I think he's really funny. I don't know if I'm Team Dorian or Team Kale yet, so I'm hoping it becomes more clear in the next books, but right now I think I'm leaning more towards Dorian just because he's funny and I like funny boys. So the next question is newest favorite character, and I'm going with two of them. Mine are Cardin and Jude from The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. I just really like them together and like their banter, and I just think they're both very snarky, and I really like snarky characters, so they're definitely high up on my list. The next question is a book that made you cry, and it is very hard to make me cry. I was going to choose this as my favorite book, but like I said, I wanted to have different books for each question, so I kind of shuffled around my favorite sequel, favorite book, and this one. So it's Daisy Jones and the Six by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This is the only Taylor Jenkins Reid book I've read. I know, shocking, I have not read Evelyn Hugo. This book actually made me cry. I was very shocked. I listened to it on audiobook. I did not expect to feel anything while reading this book, but I gotta say, it's a tearjerker. You're gonna cry. Even if you think that you're not gonna cry, you're probably gonna cry. The next question is a book that makes you happy, and I'm going with Death Prefers Blonde by Caleb Roberg. And this is literally a book about drag queens on heist missions. And I love drag queens, and this book was so funny. I laughed so much while reading it. Definitely makes me happy. Definitely a very underrated book, so you guys should check it out. But it's a good one. The next question is most beautiful book that you've bought this year, and I wouldn't say that it's the most beautiful, but something about this cover just makes me so aesthetically happy. It is The Best Lies by Sarah Liu. I don't know why I love it so much, but I really do. I think it's like the colors, but then also like the melting lollipop. I just really enjoy it. I don't know why. Might be weird. Have I read this book? No, but this is another one that I really want to read, and I believe that is out now. It comes out in July 2019. I don't know the actual date. Oop, July 2nd. So it's released now. Go check it out. Might be really good, might be really bad. I don't know. But the cover is pretty. And then the final question is, what books do you need to read by the end of the year? And I have a lot of books that I can mention, but I'm only going to mention one so that we keep this video short, and it is King of Fools by Amanda Foody. This is the second book in the Ace of Shades trilogy, duology. I don't know if it's a trilogy or a duology. I can't remember. I loved the first book. I'm almost done this one. I'm about like 60% through, and I'm loving it. So I really need to finish it. I've been reading it since April because I actually got an e-arc of it off of NetGalley. And then I bought the real book because I didn't read it in time because I'm trash, but it will be done. All right, guys, so that was the mid-year freakout book tag. Let me know down below your favorite book for this year so far. And also, if you have not done this tag, consider yourself tagged. And I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.